So for Law Week this year, College of Law has decided to focus on cybersecurity as a particular issue that's relevant to the legal community at the moment. I've been asked to contribute some of the things that I know about and have been working on in relation to how domestic legislation in Australia has developed to deal with some of the challenges posed by cyber.
So for me, the interesting thing here is the ambivalence or sets of responses that individuals have to public surveillance. On the one hand, people often get really worried, angry and concerned when government's spying on them, but at the same time, all of us seem to carry mobile phones around that watch us while we sleep, where we record our eating, you know, change relationship status, all of these sorts of things. So there's a really strange tension going on there between the government, okay, we're worried that they might be spying on us, how dare they, and at the same time, Apple or Law, Microsoft or whoever is watching us at all times and getting intimate details of our lives. Where things become interesting now is the bleed between companies and government. So government is relying on a lot of this public information, and also companies are doing a lot of stuff for government.
I've been looking at two recent enactments of the Commonwealth Parliament, so the Foreign Influence Transparency Scheme and then the Assistance and Access Act. So the first scheme is really interesting. It deals with trying to shine a light on and make more transparent where there's foreign influence on our political processes. And the cyber dimension to that is that it is now much more easy for people with a connection to a foreign principal or a foreign government to be able to influence political discourse in Australia, given that we're in a globally interconnected world through the internet, than it was, say, 30 or 40 years ago.
So a couple of days ago, there was a really interesting tweet by the Israeli military forces, and they said that they had bombed a building that Hamas had been using that was the basis for some cyber operations. So where this is interesting is Israel were using kinetic and standard military means to potentially stop a set of cyber activities. Some people question whether this actually happened, some people suggest that it might be a piece of propaganda. But if it's true, the interesting thing here is you've got military operations in response to and directly targeted at cyber activities. So we're not at risk of militarising cyberspace, it's happening.
I think one of the most important things to remember with cyber is that although it gets talked about as its own standalone thing, it's actually what's known as a vector. Cyber in and of itself is not a threat. It's what people can do within cyberspace and using that technology that creates a challenge that we have to deal with or an opportunity that we need to exploit.